This video introduces a quite wonderful function, which is known in the aggregation field as the Choquet integral. One of the defining advantages of the Choquet integral compared to other types of averages is that it takes into account how variables interact with one another, which it does by means of what's called a capacity or fuzzy measure. A prototypical example runs something like this. Suppose we have three workers and we want to understand their productivity. Let's say together, working for a day, they're able to produce one crate of goods. Now individually, it might be that Mello produces 0.2 crates, Candace produces 0.5 crates, and Nika produces 0.3, which would make sense because this adds to 1. And we could infer then that Candace and Mello together produce 0.7 crates, Mello and Nika produce 0.5, and Candace and Nika produce 0.8. However, it might not always work like this. Productivity isn't always additive. Individually, let's say Mello can produce 0.5 crates, Candace 0.7, and Nika 0.1. But then maybe Mello and Candace talk all the time when they work together, so they're only a little more productive than when Candace works by herself. And on the other hand, maybe Nika and Mello work really well as a team and are able to produce even more than they can individually by cooperating. These values, taken across all subsets, comprise what's called a capacity or a fuzzy measure. It's a set function, so it takes a set as an input and then produces a real number as an output. It has some further rules, such as the measure of the empty set being zero, which in our context just means that no workers means no production, and the value of a set can't decrease when elements are added to it. So this would mean that even if Mello and Candace do talk a lot, their potential output can't be less than when Candace works by herself or when Mello works by himself. Now let's go back to the Choquet integral. You might have an understanding of integrals as measuring the area below a functional curve, and that one way of calculating this is by looking at what happens when we approximate the area with rectangles, whose heights are the function values and whose widths we set to get smaller and smaller and smaller. This process of breaking the function into vertical rectangles is what's known as the Riemann integral. In order to deal theoretically with some problematic functions, a method that's equivalent for positive and well-behaving functions was developed and is known as the Lebesgue integral, which is defined with respect to an additive measure. Here we divide up our area horizontally, and we now look at taking smaller and smaller heights. In this case, we multiply the heights by the combined widths of the set of values for which the function is above a particular value t. Let's have a look at some friendly step functions. Taking the Riemann integral works this way, and taking the Lebesgue integral works this way. Now the Choquet integral works horizontally too. The only difference is that we no longer assume our widths to be proportionate to the elements included in each set. Each of the widths of these pseudo-rectangles are determined by the fuzzy measure values of the corresponding subset. So here's Mello, Candace, and Nika again, and the height of the bars might indicate how much of the day they've worked for. In this case, all three start working together, then Mello goes home, leaving Nika and Candace, then Candace by herself. We need to keep in mind that these widths depend on the productivity of the groups, and that the width of Candace and Nika would not necessarily be equal to the width associated with Candace and Nika together. So we've shown a little about how the Choquet integral relates to other integrals, and how we still can loosely interpret it as measuring the area or production underneath a graph. However, the Choquet integral is also often thought of as a kind of mean or averaging function. Relating it back to our step functions, the arithmetic mean can be seen as taking the sum of vertically cut rectangles where we multiply each of the input values by their width. Of course, the combined area would be the same using horizontal rectangles. The weighted arithmetic mean can be interpreted as changing the widths of these rectangles. And in each case, the Choquet integral will produce exactly the same result, because the fuzzy measure we use would amount to adding up each subset of weights or horizontal widths. Let's go through an example with Mello, Candace, and Nika so that we can get a feel for the numerical calculation. Recall our fuzzy measure weights from earlier, where Mello and Candace are less productive than the sum of their individual outputs, while Mello and Nika are more productive than the sum of their parts. Now we take our set of inputs that we want to calculate the output for. In this case, 0.4, 0.3, and 0.6, which give the respective knockoff times of each of the three workers. This means that for the first 0.3 of a day, all three are working together, so we'll multiply this by their combined productivity rate, which is 1. Mello goes home 0.4 of the way through the day, so for 0.1 of a day, it'll be he and Nika together, and then Nika will be by herself for the last 0.2 of a day. Multiplying all of these out should give you 0.4 crates as their total production. Now, although we usually think of these horizontal rectangles, we can actually think of breaking down that pseudo area vertically. We'd then be looking at the effective weight associated with each of the inputs in a comparable way to the weighted arithmetic mean. We still proceed in order from smallest to largest, so for Candace's 0.3 of a day, her effective contribution rate is what the three of them achieve together minus what Mello and Nika do as a pair. Mello's 0.4 is then multiplied by his marginal contribution, which is his productivity with Nika minus Nika's productivity alone. And Nika's score is associated with her individual productivity. You should see from these two sums that if you multiply out the brackets and rearrange, you have exactly the same output. So it's just a different way of interpreting the function. So this has been an introduction to the Choquet integral. Hopefully it has helped you gain an appreciation of how we can think about it intuitively, and some of its advantages in terms of flexibility when modeling, but also the difficulties one might face in having to identify or use all these subset values.